Sepulchre is the most difficult boss in all of Dragon Fable. You're not even supposed to win this fight against him, but today we're going to find out if we can somehow defeat him in 2020. We'll treat this as a normal fight at first to see what we've got here. We'll use our strongest attack. As you can see, we miss every strike. As Sepulchre retaliates, all of RMP is gone in his first strike. We can no longer use any of our skills that cost MP, so except for these skills that aren't really going to help us here, we are only able to attack with the regular attack button. Of course, we miss again, and Sepulchre attacks us again and afflicts us with sleep. We can try to restore our MP by drinking a mana potion, like so, but as you can see, as Sepulchre attacks again, our MP has been completely drained once more before we can even try to use one of our skills. So we have to keep using the attack button and keep missing like this. And he keeps chipping away, very quickly draining practically all of our HP so far. We can inspect the enemy, and as you can see, he has some amazing stats, amazing, even better defenses, which is why we keep missing him. His element of attack is darkness. And the resistances, as you can see, we cannot immobilize him, and he has a 99 all resistance, which means that if we even hit him, the incoming attack will be reduced to 1% of the damage it would have done. His HP and MP are also off the charts. We can stall right now by drinking a health potion, but that's not going to win us this fight, so I'll just try to attack him again, miss, and inevitably be defeated. As you can see, we've encountered two main problems here. We need to be able to deal damage, and we need to be able to survive. And seeing as Sepulchre has a resistance of 99 all and has a massive amount of HP, we'll need to survive a long, long time. So we need to be able to survive indefinitely. Now, the best armor we can use to win this fight is the Paladin armor. Because you might think, how are we going to survive 100 turns, an indefinite amount of turns, if we can't use MP to heal ourselves? But the Paladin armor has an innate skill that heals the user every turn, and the heal increases over time until it hits a certain maximum. So that's how we're going to survive. The heal is not that great, it won't be over 100 HP probably, and Sepulchre deals many hundreds of HP in damage per turn, so we'll also need to reduce the incoming damage, and we're going to need to increase the heal of the Paladin armor. Now, how are we going to do that? First of all, we're going to redistribute our stats. The heal that the Paladin armor has is dependent on your endurance stat. Let me reset those stats real quick. The heal, as I said, is proportionate to the endurance stat. The greater your endurance stat is, the greater your maximum health is, and the greater your maximum health is, the greater the heal of the armor will be per turn. So you want to max that out all the way to 200 if possible. Then you'll want to increase your wisdom stat, because wisdom not only increases your amount of mana, which is pointless because he drains all of our mana, but it also increases healing and, more importantly even, bonus to hit, because we need to be able to hit Sepulchre eventually. Let's do this to 200 and endurance to 195. So train, and as you can see, our health and MP stats have increased quite a lot. Next, what we want to do is increase our darkness resistance stat, because Sepulchre only deals damage of the darkness element. You want to increase your darkness resistance by using equipment that has a lot of darkness resistance and all resistance. For example, the Necrotic Sword of Doom, the Doom Knight Helmet, Wings of the Thousand Infernos, the Dragon's Defender Necklace, Star-Studded Belt, Sir Malefact's Doom, the Soul Purifier Trinket, and the Legion Bracer. Now, let's take a look at our new resistances. We now have a Darkness Resistance of 74, but we also have an All Resistance of 18, which stack. the all resistance and the darkness resistance combined is our total resistance to darkness, which is 92. Which means that 92% of the incoming damage Sepulture does to us will be negated. Now, just to top it all off, we want to increase our chances of healing by equipping our dragon as a pet, and I advise you to train it in protection as high as possible. Summon dragon as pet, alright. Now let's take a crack at the fight again. We haven't been able to do anything to keep our MP, so this first attack is the only attack we can use with MP. And what I recommend doing is increasing your darkness resistance with this first attack. That way you will take even less damage in the beginning, which is good because the heal of the paladin armor needs to build up over time. So we'll just do that. Sadly, we still miss. So our dragon can protect ourselves. All of MP, our MP is drained. But look at the damage of Sepulture. 2 damage, 3 damage, 2 damage in his multi-strike attack. So we've only sustained 3 damage here. And our darkness resistance, due to the skill that we use, is now 114 for the next 4 turns. Sadly, a single resistance is capped at 80, and the combined resistance with all is capped at 99. So we will never be able to heal from Sepulture's attacks, because we won't be able to have a resistance over 100. Alright, so then we'll just try to attack him, and with each attack our inner light grows, which means our heal of the paladin armor grows stronger. Sadly, we still miss our attacks on Sepulture, but Sepulture still barely does any damage to us, and our heal is increased from 9 to 14. We'll fast forward by doing this a couple of turns to increase our healing ability to its maximum. Now, we're a good amount of turns into the battle, and your inner light is a beacon of your power, is the message now, which means that our healing ability has increased to the maximum of 92 per turn. Now let's see if Sepulture is still able to netto decrease our HP, or if we're able to steadily increase our HP over time. As you can see, our health has been steadily increasing over time, which would mean that Sepulture is no longer able to decrease our HP to zero. We don't even need to use our 2 aces, which I'll explain in a second, in case you don't have the stats to accomplish the current state. Our trinket that we use, which is the Soul Purifier, because of its darkness resistance, by sheer luck, also has a healing ability here that does not require MP to use. So if we use it, we can restore to our max HP from our current state. And also, our dragon could heal us, like so. But we're already practically at max HP, but he healed us for 313 health. These are the damage overtimes, but luckily, they don't affect our HP, but their damage over time effects for our MP, so that even if we try to restore our mana with a skill that the paladin class has, it'll still be drained. It'll be drained by Sepulture's attack regardless, but it would also be drained by these leech damage overtimes. So in conclusion, I would say that the goal of being able to survive indefinitely against Sepulture has been a complete success. Which brings us to the bad news, which you may already probably have guessed, is that in this entire battle so far, we have not been able to hit Sepulture for a single time. We can even use our dragon to attack a couple of times, but each attack, without fail, misses Sepulture. I believe Sepulchre does expend his own MP when he uses attacks, so I thought maybe we can drag the battle out until he has no MP left himself, and then maybe we can take him down, because then he won't be able to drain our MP maybe. But see, it went down the number of MPs when he used this attack. But eventually, he also apparently has a skill that heals his MP, and I think he also heals his HP by a certain extent. Here we see the special ability of the Necrotic Blade of Doom, but every attack misses Sepulchre once again. Given Sepulchre's, as you can see, healing abilities for his stats, his massive amount of health, and the fact that we, even with a wisdom stat of 200, or 236, we haven't been able to hit Sepulchre for a single time, I have to say that it seems like we cannot take Sepulchre down after all. I'm going to count this challenge, the challenge is a fail, because the challenge was defeating Sepulchre in 2020, which does not appear to be possible, but, oh, we hit him, we got 2 damage! Wow, yeah, let's see if he heals, yes, he heals that 2 HP in an instant, oh man. So, we can't defeat him, but then again, he can't defeat us either, so unless we maybe unequip our items, we're in a soft lock here, because neither of us can win or lose, which means we fought this Sepulchre to a draw. Which is impressive in its own right, if I do say so myself. If you have ideas as to how I can deal damage to Sepulchre, how we can actually beat him sometime, that would be amazing, that would be great. But so far, that's the best we can do, I think, right now. So thank you all so much for watching. Be sure to smash that like. Oh, no, we're not doing that. For those of you wondering what the hell I'm doing, this game is, as I said in the beginning, called Dragon Fable, and it is by far my favorite game of all time. The mechanics may be a bit slow, so I think it's not that entertaining to watch a let's play of it, but I did want to showcase this and to show how the game works by trying to beat this impossible fight. Anyway, I wish you all the best of luck in 2020, and until the next time.